about the history, then classification, indications and contraindications, composition, the clinical procedures, setting, reaction of GIC, the different properties of GIC, both physical, chemical, mechanical and biological properties, then the few applications of GIC, modifications, recent advances, and we are concluding. That means we just go through all these and finally there will be a conclusion. So, what is a cement? A cement is a substance that hardens to act as a base, liner, filling material or adhesive to bind devices or processes to the tool structure or to each other. This may be explained by Phillips. Glass cinema is a water-based cement and it comes under ADA specification number 96. During the last decades, an increasing variety of dental perspiration materials have conquered the market. Mainly internal perspiration includes gold and ceramics, whereas in the past, that is during the olden times, amalgam was considered to be the gold standard. But considering the aesthetic point of view, we are going into glass enamel cement. That is, today the decreased number of amalgam fillings is also influenced by a high demand for tooth color and biocompatible restorations. Great strides in dental research have led to a variety of alternatives to amalgam, one of which is glass enamel cement. We are going into detail about this cement. In dentistry, adhesion of perspiration materials to tooth substance is an important objective. It is adhesion to tooth structure. It may be in case of glass enamel cement, it may be a chemical adhesion. In case of composite, it is a micromechanical. Whereas amalgam, it is only macromechanical. It is mechanical adhesion. So, the adhesive property here, we are giving importance to the adhesive property of the perspiration material. It is believed that a restorative material should resemble to tooth in all respects. The glass enamel cements are one of the products developed in this direction. It is considering the both aesthetics as well as adhesive property, both these properties. So we are concentrating into these two properties. Glass enamel cement are described as a hybrid of dental silicate cements and zinc polycarbonates. They are combination of these cements. Glass enamel cements are materials made of calcium, strontium, aluminum silicate, glass water, which acts as a base to bind in a water soluble polymer acid. By definition, by Kenneth J. and Service, glass enamel is the generic name of a group of materials that use silicate glass powder and act as a solution of polyacrylic acid. So, by definition, should be thorough with the definition. Glass enamel cement is a basic glass and an acidic polymer which sets for an acid-base reaction between these components, mainly explained by McLean, Nicholson and Wilson. So, different views or different way of explaining the definition of glass enamel cement by different authors. GIC, that is glass enamel cement, acquired its name from its composition of glass particles and an enamel that contains carboxylic acid. Extensive use of this cement to replace dentin has given it different names. So it is known to us in different names. That is, it is known as dental substitute, man-made dentin, artificial dentin, or aspart. That is, aluminum silicate polyacrylic acid. So, all these four which have been mentioned here denotes glass enamel cement. It is mainly in Viva, they used to ask man-made dentin, so it is GIC. For the history, so it has got a vast history, but we just go through mention some of the history aspect. basic component is a calcium chloroaluminum silicate glass. The liquid part consists of polyacrylic acid, which is co-polymerized with other carbolic acids like hydrochloric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, and water. Here, the presence of water is said to be critical. That means too much of water and too less of water can cause differences in the final sex cement. So, it is said that the presence of water is critical. Water is an important constituent of GIC and it acts as the reaction medium as well as it finally hydrates the products. So, initially it acts as the reaction medium. That means, in order to initiate the reaction, the presence of water is important. In the absence of water, the reaction will not take place. So, the presence of water is critical. The three acids, that is, hydrochloric, malic, and tricarboxylic acid, decrease the viscosity of the liquid. It promotes reactivity and its prevent generation of the liquid. Tartaric acid, it increases the working time. Increases translucency, improves manageability, that means more time, we get more time. It increases the strength. Polyphosphates extends the working time, metal or whereas metal oxides accelerates the setting time. Coming to different types of classifications, of which the main, that is basic classification, everyone should know this classification because we are mainly concerned with the clinical aspect of GIC. So, according to use, in different types of respirations, we can use different types of GIC. That is, type 1 can be used for one thing, type 2 as a respiratory GIC, type 3 as minors and bases, type 4 beneficial signals, type 5 beauty for operatic purpose. That is for using operatic bands and brackets. Type 6 for core beta material. Type 7, high fluoride releasing command set. That is, command set means once, what do you mean by command set? In case of pharmacies, the command set means once you use light, it's in your hands, and you, once you use light, it will start setting. It's not an acid-based reaction, it's a command set. Type 8, an achromatic respiratory treatment. Okay, achromatic. That is ART technique.